Hi everyone! It's time for another Plex-Earth video. In this tutorial, we will show you how we can snap a CAD object onto a terrain model created with Plex-Earth 5D. This island is the study area for a project where we would like to install wind turbines in specific locations. First of all, make sure that the joints to reference settings have been defined. More information about this procedure can be found on our website. In order to perform this procedure, there must be an existing terrain model to work on. If you do not have a terrain model, you can import one using Plex-Earth 5D. Let's quickly import the terrain for this island. First, click on the Import Terrain button from the Plex-Earth 5D ribbon. Next, choose your preferred terrain provider and specify the terrain cover area. We will do that in the drawing and by selecting this polyline that outlines our project area. Within a few seconds, a dynamic terrain is now available in our CAD workspace. Then, we can insert the objects that we want to snap in our drawing. To do so, go to the Insert tab and click Insert. Pick the object to import in the drawing and click on the points where we want the object to be placed. We will be inserting this 3D wind turbine model. Depending on various needs, we can specify an insertion point and choose some other options available in the command line. In order to snap an object onto the terrain using Plex-Earth 5D, we need to have a terrain mesh object in our CAD workspace as the terrain initially imported is a dynamic object unique to Plex-Earth. To do this, click on the Insert button located in the Terrain Editor palette and choose Thin Mesh. Let's insert the mesh object, and here it is! Immediately available in the drawing. We can now proceed with snapping the wind turbines onto the terrain. Click on the terrain drop-down box in the terrain panel and choose Snap Objects. We will then be asked to specify the target type and choose between surface and elevation. By choosing surface, the object will be snapped on top of the terrain, and by choosing elevation, the height for the objects can be manually specified. Let's choose surface for this video. Then, we will be prompted to select the terrain mesh and the objects to snap onto it. After that, the anchor point must be specified for Plex-Earth to know which point it will use as a basis for placing the model on the surface. We'll be choosing the bottom part and hit Enter. And just like that, we can now visualize our wind turbines in their environment and investigate the area of installation. The level of visualization can be further improved in CAD by converting the imagery for our area of interest and terrain into 3D imagery. Just like this. That was quick and easy, isn't it? Try it out yourself and don't hesitate to contact our support team if you have any questions. Hope you enjoyed watching and see you in another Plex-Earth video.